So you want to learn what the best supplements are to support your jiu-jitsu on and off the mats. Out of the thousands and thousands of supplements in the billion-dollar industry, I've curated a list of 4 different categories of supplements that are going to support your jiu-jitsu. First, we have supplements to support muscle. Second is athletic performance. Third is recovery. And last but not least is joint health. So let's get into it. Supplements are not a substitute for a shit diet. If you're eating a shit diet, check out my ultimate jiu-jitsu nutrition guide. Link is in the description. First up is muscle recovery. In this category, I've ranked them as number 1, creatine, number 2, protein powders, and number 3, essential amino acids. Creatine is essentially the most well-researched supplement that you can buy. It is hands down my highest recommended supplement to all of my nutrition clients, and I recommend you give it a go. The dosage is 5 grams per day. Have it around carbohydrate loaded meals because your absorption will be a little bit better. The reason you want to supplement with creatine is by supplementing with creatine, you're going to saturate your muscle cells with creatine phosphate stores. Essentially, what this means is your body will have more energy during bursts of exercise output on the jiu-jitsu mats. So this may be the difference between getting someone off mount or escaping a submission or what have you, because you have the extra oomph to do it. Next up is protein powders. The nutritionist in me hates the fact that I've included this on a supplement list, but unless you're calculating your macros and you're tracking your food, it can be a supplement as well. Normally, I consider this as a food source. Protein powders come in so many shapes, forms, flavors, colors, fucking advertisement campaigns, you name it. So focus on the 3 main ones: whey protein concentrate, whey protein isolate, and casein. First up, whey protein concentrate, or WPC, is the most common form of protein powder you're going to find, and it's generally the cheapest. It's okay, but it has a little bit more fat and carbohydrate than its younger brother, whey protein isolate, or WPI. Whey protein isolate is a double filtered version of whey protein and has way more protein per gram than its brother, whey protein concentrate. And last but certainly not least is casein. You may know casein as the slow release protein. That's because it takes your body a little bit more time to digest the protein because they're larger protein molecules, and your body digests casein a little bit more slowly. So it's a slow release of protein. My recommendation is stick with right in the middle, WPI. The reason for that is you're gonna get more bang for buck, more protein per gram, and it's fast acting, fast releasing. We won't worry about casein. We can get that sort of protein slow release from our food. The third supplement I wanna talk about in this category is essential amino acids. The reason I recommend EAAs over BCAAs is because the research points to the fact that EAAs are actually going to improve your muscle protein synthesis, whereas branched chain amino acids do not. There's actually been research to suggest that BCAAs can reduce the amount of muscle protein synthesis, and there is a very awesome and lengthy explanation for that. If you want to check out why I recommend EAAs over BCAAs, check out the podcast I did with Jungle Brothers. Link is in the description, where we delve into all things nutrition, supplements, and of course, EAAs versus BCAAs. Next category of supplements is athletic performance. The 3 types of supplements I want to talk about here are caffeine, hydrolyte, and pre-workouts. First up, let's talk about caffeine. Caffeine comes in so many different sources, but the most common is coffee, pre-workouts, and energy drinks. Try to avoid having caffeine 8 hours prior to bed. So if you're like me and you train in the evenings, I recommend not supplementing with caffeine to support your jiu-jitsu. If you want to experiment what it's like to roll with a whole bunch of caffeine on board your system, then try it out a couple times. But just note, of course, if you're a slow caffeine metabolizer like I am, then you probably won't be sleeping that night. Next up, I want to talk about hydrolyte or electrolyte powders. So electrolytes are basically lost in your sweat at jiu-jitsu. Electrolyte, basically, we're talking about minerals and salts. So think sodium. I highly recommend avoiding your Gatorades to get your electrolytes. Yeah, it's a good source of electrolytes, but you're also packaging it with a lot of carbohydrate in the form of simple sugars. So what I recommend is, if you are someone that sweats a lot, you're training very hard, you're doing a 2.5 hour jiu-jitsu session or an open mat or something like that, and you know you're going balls to the wall, maybe dose with some electrolyte powders immediately before and during your session to support with rehydration. Because when you sweat a lot, you lose a lot of minerals and salts from your sweat, and water is not going to do the job to rehydrate you in all cases. Next, I wanted to talk about pre-workouts. Now, I personally do not recommend pre-workouts for jiu-jitsu. The reason for this is you don't want to be spazzing out on pre-workouts, or you don't want to be taking a ridiculous amount of caffeine. Predominantly, the active ingredient in the vast majority of pre-workouts is caffeine. Now, a lot of pre-workouts are also packaged with things like taurine, beta-alanine, and creatine, but a lot of these extra supplements that are in your pre-workouts aren't dose-dependent, which means you don't actually need to take them pre-workout to get the benefits. A prime example of this is creatine and beta-alanine. Beta-alanine is the stuff that gives you all the tingles and makes your face really itchy when you're taking pre-workout. That's not dose dependent. You don't need to take a pre-workout to get the benefits. And to be honest, I don't recommend beta-alanine anymore because the research doesn't really show all that great of a benefit. So the cost versus benefit is pretty low. Unless you really want to spend the money, I recommend against beta-alanine. The third category of supplements I wanted to talk about is supplements that support your recovery. The three supplements I'm talking about here are magnesium, zinc, and vitamin D. Let's start with magnesium. Magnesium deficiency is the second most common deficiency in the first world. So supplementing with magnesium can be a good idea. Supplementing with magnesium is essentially going to help your recovery because it is a very good muscle relaxant and it's going to support you during sleep. Magnesium also has a whole host of other health benefits, but in terms of relating to jiu-jitsu, just think it's going to help your recovery by helping you relax after training and help your sleep quality. I recommend taking your magnesium as directed on your magnesium supplement bottle just before bed. Next up, let's talk about zinc. If you're a dude and you're a massive wanker, you're ejaculating a lot, chances are you may have a zinc deficiency. Now, I'm not actually joking about this. When men ejaculate, you lose zinc. Zinc is very important to maintain, particularly for men, because it supports your testosterone production. It also supports your immune system. So the less sick days you have, the more time you have on the mats. And third for recovery, we have vitamin D. Now, I mentioned that magnesium was the second most common deficiency in the first world. The first is actually vitamin D. Particularly during the winter months, vitamin D levels amongst the first world can be quite shithouse. The reason is we're not getting a lot of sun. A bit of trivia for you, vitamin D is actually not a vitamin, it is a hormone. It is a hormone that is produced in the body, which is stimulated by sun exposure. So what does vitamin D actually do in your body? Well, it's a hormone that helps with the production of other hormones, it helps with your cell membranes, and a whole host of other metabolic processes within the body. So I highly recommend supplementing with vitamin D if you are deficient. How do you know you're deficient? Refer to your doctor and get a test. I don't recommend just going straight into supplementing with vitamin D because it is a fat-soluble vitamin. And what that means is essentially it needs fat to be absorbed in your body. So if you take vitamin D in excessive amounts, particularly when you're not consuming any fats, vitamin D may store in your body and it becomes toxic. The difference between a fat-soluble vitamin and a water-soluble vitamin, take vitamin D being the fat-soluble and say vitamin C, a water-soluble, is you can effectively overdose on vitamin D, whereas you can't on vitamin C because you'll just pee it out. So the fourth category of supplements that I want to talk about is supplements that support your joint health. The supplement that I'm talking about here is glucosamine chondroitin. This 1-2 combo supplement has been shown in various studies to support joint health and restore range of motion in patients with osteoarthritis. So there hasn't really been any research into this supplement supporting people in the athletic population like jiu-jitsu athletes, but the research in the osteoarthritis clinical population is very promising. So this is one if you are concerned about joint health or you're a sufferer of creaky joints from the jits, then maybe you should check it out and see if it works for you. Now, I personally don't recommend going out and buying it just willy-nilly to experiment, but if joint health is a concern for you, maybe it is worth giving a go. So check it out. So there you have it. Those are my four categories of supplements that I recommend giving a go to support your jiu-jitsu on and off the mats. If you want to learn more about supplements, highly recommend checking out examine.com for all things supps. I put a link link to everything that I spoke about in the description below if you want to check it out. Also, if you are interested in leveling up your jiu-jitsu through the power of nutrition, check out my ultimate jiu-jitsu nutrition guide. Link is in the description. Thanks for watching today's video. If you got something out of it, consider giving me a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. It really does help to support the channel grow. What supplements do you take? Is there any supplements that weren't on the list that you expected to be on the list? Or maybe you've taken some supplements that you found really do help to level up your jiu-jitsu or support your recovery or athletic performance? Let me know in the comments and we can start a discussion and find out what other people are using and what works and what doesn't. Thanks for watching.